This morning I will be talking upon the book Working with Emotional Intelligence by Daniel Goleman. Daniel Goleman is an author and a science journalist. Emotional intelligence is the ability to identify, assess, and control one's own emotions of others and that with the groups. Nowadays, in any workplace or in dealing in any situations in life, we all require emotional intelligence in order to be successful. In this book, Daniel Goleman provided the framework of emotional competence, which are of personal competence and social competence. Personal competencies determines how we handle ourselves by self-awareness, self-regulation, and motivation. Self-awareness determines how we know, we understand our own emotions and their effect, and having and knowing their strengths and its limitations, and having self-confidence in our own capabilities. Self-regulations means managing our own internal impulses and resources by being self-controlled, innovative, conscious, and adaptable. Motivation. Emotional tendencies that guides and facilitates towards our reaching our goals is being committed, is by being committed, optimistic, and initiative. For example, Clara, being a mother of a one-year-old child, and as well as working as a human resource manager in a company, if suppose the child falls sick during the night and she has to look after the child, and early morning she has to wake up and get ready for her job, as well as to bear and take care of her husband and her child. Then, as she goes out to work, and in the working environment, she will not let all that frustration of sleepless nights and tired body affect her working environment. Instead, she would be focused determinedly and productively in her work. Social responsibilities. Social competencies determines how we handle relationships with others and understanding their feelings, needs, and concerns. That is empathy. In this book, Daniel pointed out a number of interesting contents in which helps us how to control and have authority on our own emotions, in which it will help us to be successful in making decisions in any workplace or in life. Under this, I would like to focus on the inner rudder. And under inner rudder, I will be focusing on 2 points, which is the source of gut feeling and position of the power of intuition. The source of gut feeling. For in any business firm, we usually take decisions based on a combination of logic and as well as gut feeling. The amygdala is a small, it's the shape of an almond of neurons which is present deep in our brains, in which acts as a process of controlling our emotions. It is like your gut is telling you something, in which triggers our mind and tightens our stomach, in which the gut is saying that this seems so right or just doesn't seem right in making such decisions. It's the same, for example, when a girl or a guy sees their crush, or the person that they like, they usually have butterflies in the stomach. So that is gut feeling. Likewise, Steve Jobs was very famous in making such critical decisions. In the year 2010, he predicted that tablets would overtake the PC one day. And following his intuition, in the same year, he launched the iPad during April, the month of April. And that decision paid off, in which Apple sold over deal is can be able to be successful or not, even if the numbers doesn't seem right. Or executives, whether should be able to take decisions whether a new product would be able or it's worth the time and money. And such decisions should be able to. And such decisions should be made in order that this would work it or not.